In this video today, I answer a question I get frequently when I speak with students. I want a career in industry. Should I do a postdoc? After more than 20 years working in industry myself, I've learned a lot about the value of a PhD as well as the value of a postdoc. In this video, I'll tell you what I've learned and I'll tell you my position on doing a postdoc if you want an industry career. Also, if you hang around to the end, I will tell you my one exception to that rule. Hey, everybody. Dave Giltner, Returning Science. So when I speak with graduate students, a question I frequently get is, I want a career in industry. Should I do a postdoc? Will a postdoc help me? And the answer that I always give is no, don't do a postdoc. It won't help you, and it just may hurt you. Why do I say that? Well, let me tell you about it. In short, if you've gotten a PhD, you've spent a lot of time in academia. And if you want to build a career in industry, it's time for you to get out there in the real world and see how that works. But when I say it just may hurt you, I have three specific things in mind. First of all, are the things you'd be learning in the postdoc. Second would be the work habits that you're developing when you do a postdoc. And third would be the impression that people in industry will have of you if you've done a postdoc. Now let me talk about all three of those in more detail so you see what I mean. So the first reason that doing a postdoc will set you back is related to the things that you learn when you're doing a postdoc. Now, if you do a postdoc, certainly you will gain technical expertise in the research field that you choose. But the chances of you getting an industry job in that same technical field actually are not very high. Far more important, far more valuable, is to get out there and learn how companies work. That's going to be much more useful to you in an industry career. Now sure, if you take a postdoc, your boss or your PI will coach you on things like doing better research, publishing more, getting research funding. You'll probably even manage a team of students and maybe even other postdocs, and that would help a lot if you want to become a professor. But it's really not going to help you very much if you want an industry career. Far more important is to get out there now and learn how companies work. So now the second way that doing a postdoc can set you back in your industry career planning is in your work habits. Working in industry and working in academia are really very different. And if you subscribe to my YouTube channel or if you've seen me speak live, you've heard me say this more than once. Well, when you get a PhD, you have spent a long time already in an academic research setting in the controlled environment of a research lab. And you learn habits, work habits, that do make you productive in an academic setting. But these same work habits often are counterproductive in an industry setting. When you do a postdoc, you're simply spending more time in that academic environment, and you're learning to think and work even more like an academic, and that can be a liability. Now, if you want to learn more about the good habits for industry, check out the video I linked to up here, titled Five Habits That PhDs Who Are Successful in Industry Learn Quickly. So the third reason that doing a postdoc can set you back in an industry career is in how people in industry will perceive you. Look, when you've done a PhD, you've already spent more time in school than almost everyone on the planet. And there are good reasons for this. When you get a PhD, you develop technical skills and a depth of understanding you would never get if you didn't do the PhD. And there's real value in that. But the fact is, a lot of people in industry will see you as an academic. And if you hang around and do a postdoc, they're going to think you really want to be an academic. They may think that you really didn't know what kind of career path you wanted. Some may actually think that or suspect that you wanted to be a professor, that you wanted an academic career path, and it just didn't work out, that maybe you weren't good enough. You don't want them thinking that about you. Managers in industry want to work with people who know what they want to do and where they want to do it. Now, the fact is, a postdoc is just not seen as the positive thing in industry that it is in academia. So don't let your advisor talk you into it simply because she sees it as the logical next step after a PhD. That may be what she did, but she took a completely different career path and the steps to get there were very different. The fact is, managers in industry want to work with people who understand solving real-world problems, not academic research problems. They want to work with people who know the difference between in theory and in practice. Now, if you're sitting there watching this video and you're thinking to yourself, you find yourself thinking of reasons why you'd still like to do a postdoc anyway, I suggest you think carefully about what those reasons really are. Now, there's a lot of standard rationalizations from it's the cultural narrative, it's the traditional path, it's what we PhDs do. My advisor recommends it or really wants me to do it. Or I'd really like to stay and gain more technical expertise. Well, I think I've addressed most of these in this video, but I want to touch on that last one again, because it's easy to fall into a habit when you're a graduate student of thinking I'm gaining lots of valuable technical knowledge. And it makes sense by that logic that if I stay and do a postdoc, I'll gain even more of that valuable technical expertise. But the fact is, in industry, your value to a company is much less about the specific technical knowledge you already have and much more about the skills and work habits. It's much less about what you've done in the past and much more about what you can do for the company in the future. So if you're serious about building a career in industry, it's really better for you to get out there now. It's time for you to get out there and start honing those skills and building that experience in the work environment where you truly want to build a career. Now, it may be that if you're truly honest with yourself, you will realize that there's yet a different reason you're still considering a postdoc. It might be that you're afraid about getting a job. And it might be that you see a postdoc as an easier transition. Get the postdoc now and you can worry about the industry job later. And I can't argue that would certainly be easier, at least in the near term. I still remember the conversation with my advisor where she said, if you want to do a postdoc, I have lots of connections and I can help you. If you want to go into industry, I have no connections there. I don't know anything about it. You're on your own. And it was very clear that the postdoc would be easier, but if I wanted to go into industry, it was going to be more challenging. But just because the postdoc is the easier approach, of course, does not mean it's the better approach. For the reasons I've listed in this video, making it easier now is only going to make it harder down the road, and that's not really a good trade. Now, it might be that you're nervous about moving out into the real world, and that's also normal, especially for those of us who have been in academia for so long. University is a controlled setting by design, and there's far more uncertainty in the private sector, so it's totally natural to feel nervous about moving out. All I'm saying is that delaying that transition isn't going to make it better. It may make it comfortable now, but it won't be better in the long run. Just remember, comfort is the enemy of progress, or as I like to say, discomfort is the price of admission for a meaningful life or a meaningful career. So if you really want an exciting and rewarding career, sometimes you have to choose the more challenging path because that's how we grow. So if when you're truly honest with yourself, you think maybe one of these is the reason you want to do a postdoc, I really urge you to reconsider. So if you're worried about getting a job and making the transition into industry now, it's okay, that's totally reasonable, and that's what I help people with. Now, it might be one of the things you're worried about is interviewing. You may be wondering, how do I convince people in industry of my value when I've got academic research experience? And if this is one of the things you're worried about, I suggest you check the video that I linked to in the description notes below. It's called 5 Plus 1 Ways to Impress a Hiring Manager. Now, this video is part of our Turning Science Academy program, so I don't have it here on YouTube, but if you click the link and drop your email, you will get it for free. I suggest you check it out. It's in the description notes right below this video. So at the beginning of this video, I said there was one exception to my no postdoc rule. What is that? Well, I speak to a pretty international crowd, and many times there are people in my audience who want to move to a new country to begin their career. And if you want to do that, one of the challenges is establishing residency and getting a visa to work in that country. If this is what you're planning to do, if you want to start your career in a new country, it may make sense for you to get a postdoc in that country as an easier way of making the transition. It could help you set up residency and start making progress on that visa. Now, you still have to consider all the negatives that I listed in this video already, but if you're really wanting to start your career in a new country, it may make sense for you to do a postdoc in that country first. Well, that's all I have to say today about doing a postdoc. Thanks for watching, and I hope you found it valuable. Now, if you like this video, please click that like icon below. It will help me, but more importantly, it will help other people who could benefit from this video because more likes means YouTube shows it to more people. And if you'd like to get more videos like this yourself, click subscribe and ring that notification bell. I post about 2 of these a month to help you build the career you really want. Thanks for watching. Now let's get out there and turn science into things people need.